Good evening, students. Today we move to the third lecture related to digital video. I am Moha Biswas. I am working as an assistant professor in Spheris College of Engineering, Pandharpur. So today we are going to cover some point bit, that is IPTV, what is a smart TV, digital surveillance and Wi-Fi TV. Let's see one by one. So, what is IPTV? So before that, we must know about the what is the meaning of IP. So IP full form is Internet Protocol, which specifies the format of packets and the addressing scheme, which establishes a virtual connection between a destination and a source. Television specifies the medium of communication that operates through the transmission of pictures and sounds. So if we go for combine these two terms, IP and television, so it specifies the medium of communication of pictures and sound that operates over an IP network. It is the delivery of television content over Internet Protocol network. It is a digital television services that receives both TV or multimedia services via internet connection. IPTV is in contrast to delivery through traditional terrestrial satellite and cable television formats. Unlike downloaded media, IPTV offers the ability to stream the source media continuously. As a result, a client media player can begin playing the content almost immediately. This is also known as streaming media. It provides all digital two-way connected unlimited channels. It provides triple play functionality, which helps to perform internet access, voice services and video services simultaneously. It also provides high-speed internet access, television and telephone. Although IPTV uses the Internet Protocol, it is not limited to television streamed from the internet. IPTV is widely deployed in subscriber-based telecommunication networks with high-speed access channels into end-user premises via set-top boxes or other customer premises equipment. IPTV is also used for media delivery around corporate and private networks. IPTV supports two kinds of services. First one is multicast IPTV, second one is unicast IPTV. So let's see one by one what is multicast. In the case of multicast IPTV, it enables a TV content provider to send TV content to many subscribers at the same time. IP multicast saves considerable bandwidth. It also supports multi-channel and sends them at the same time. It divides channels into groups and sends to each user the group that contains the requested channel. Second one is the unicast IPTV. In the case of unicast IPTV, it sends a given TV content to a given user. Video on demand like Netflix online movie website is a typical service of IPTV, which enables a user to request a specific movie and to receive it on his or her TV set. IPTV is defined as the secure and reliable delivery to subscribers of entertainment, video and related services. These services may include, for example, live TV, video on demand and interactive TV. These services are delivered across an access agnostic packet switch network that employs the IP protocol to transport the audio, video and control signals. In contrast to video over the public internet, with IPTV deployments, network security and performance are tightly managed to ensure a superior entertainment experience resulting in a compelling business environment for content providers, advertisers and customers alike. There are three types of IPTV, already I have discussed. First one is video on demand. So video on demand, for example, Netflix online movie website. It select a TV program or movie we want to watch from a wide range and pay your money and watch it there and then. Second one is time shifted IPTV. Last week programs available online using a web-based streaming video player called the BBC iPlayer. And live IPTV, for example, Fox Sports, broadcasting live TV programs across the internet as they are being watched. So typically, the IPTV network shown in figure is separated into three physical locations: the video serving office, VSO, the local end office, that is LEO, and the viewer's home. The VSO is responsible for gathering video from a variety of sources and converting the signals into IP video streams. The LEO is responsible for combining video data and voice signals into a form that can be transmitted over a network to the home. In this example, digital subscriber loop, that is DSL technology, is being used. So the LEO contains a DSL access multiplexer to format the signals. Inside the home, the incoming signal is split and reformatted for a number of purposes, including telephone services, high-speed data service, and video that is fed to a television by way of an IPTV set-top box. The IPTV has been widely used since around 2002 to distribute television and audiovisual media around businesses and commercial sites, whether as live TV channels or video on demand. Examples of types of commercial users include airports, schools, offices, hotels, and sports stadiums, to name just a few. There are many elements which comes under the IPTV. The first one is the IPTV headend, where live TV channels and audio video sources are encoded, encrypted and delivered in the form of IP multicast streams. Second one is the video on demand platform, where on demand video assets are stored and served as IP unicast streams when a user makes a request. The video on demand platform may sometimes be located with and considered part of the IPTV headend. Third one is the interactive portal. It allows the user to navigate within the different IPTV services such as video on demand catalog. Fourth one is delivery network. The packet switch network that carries IP packets, that it may be unicast or multicast. Next is the endpoints, user equipment that can request, decode and deliver IPTV streams for display to the user. This can include computers and mobile devices as well as set-top boxes. Next is the home TV gateway. It is a piece of equipment at a residential IPTV user's home that terminates the access link from the delivery network. And last one is the user set-top box. It is a piece of endpoint equipment that decodes and decrypts TV and video on demand streams for display on the TV screen. Depending on the network architecture of the service provider, there are two main types of video service server architecture that can be considered for IPTV deployment. First one is the centralized and second one is the distributed. The centralized architecture model is a relatively simple and easy to manage solution. Because all media content is stored in centralized servers, it does not require a comprehensive content distribution system. Centralized architecture is generally good for a network that provides relatively small video on demand service deployment, which has adequate core and edge bandwidth and has an efficient content delivery network. In the case of distributed architecture, it is just as scalable as a centralized model. However, it has bandwidth usage advantages and inherent system management features that are essential for managing a larger server network. Operators who plan to deploy a relatively large system should therefore consider implementing a distributed architecture model right from the start. Let's see what are the advantages of IPTV. So first one is the integration. So it means several services bundled and transmitted via single line, hence cost is reduced. Second one is the provide other services such as multimedia or interactivity. Third one is content remains in the network and only the content the consumer selects is sent into the customer's home. Fourth one is parental controls can be set so that their child can watch a documentary for a school report while they are away from the home. Fifth one is programs can be recorded and stored in set-top box for future watchable purpose. Sixth, robust and scalable service delivery. And last one is IPTV covers both the live TV as well as video on demand. What is the disadvantages? Because IPTV uses internet protocol, it is sensitive to packet loss and delays if the streamed data is unreliable. Second one is if the IPTV connection is not fast enough, picture breakup or loss may occur. Next one is the smart TV. A smart TV is also known as connected TV, that is CTV. It is a new generation of television. A smart TV is a traditional television set with integrated internet and interactive Wave 2.0 features, which allows user to stream music and videos, browse the internet and view photos. Smart TV is a television set or set-top box that can be connected to the internet and enables the user to download and use TV-specific applications and browse the Wave directly from the TV. By connecting the TV to a wireless network, the TV can communicate with other devices on the network like computers, smartphones and tablets. It gives the user the ability to pass content between the TV and the other devices and control the TV from their smart products. Senior research analyst at e-consultancy Monica Seviut talks about the 5 C's of connected TV. First one is the convergence, which means the merging of broadcast and online entertainment onto a TV screen. Second one is the choice. The TV also has to provide a user-friendly way to switch between broadcasting, online and stored TV content. Third one is companion. Companion applications are becoming an important part of the experience of watching TV. Startups are launching TV companion applications with interactive social media features to further engage the users and boost TV ratings. TV operators are also beginning to incorporate social activities into their shows, such as live tweeting, showing curated tweets, and launching Facebook apps for live voting. Fourth one is cord cutting. In the case of cord cutting, it refers to the act of cancelling the satellite and cable TV subscriptions. With more and more TV content available online and on-demand applications available, speculations about their people are going to cut the cord and cancel their cable and satellite subscription is being made. Online users can watch what they want, when they want, and pay for exactly what they use instead of paying a fixed amount of money every month to the cable company for channels that they may not even watch. And last one is the competition and corporation. The growing premises of connected TV have intensified the competition between different TV organizations, such as Google and Apple, are developing their hardware and service platforms to provide a potential replacement of traditional TV. Smart TV is a technological convergence of computers, television sets and set-top boxes. Besides the traditional functions of television sets and set-top boxes provided through traditional broadcasting media, These devices can also provide internet TV, online interactive media, over-the-top content, as well as on-demand streaming media and home networking access. Smart TVs should not be confused with internet TV, IPTV or web television. Internet TV refers to receiving television content over the internet instead of traditional systems such as terrestrial cable and satellite, regardless how the internet is delivered. IPTV is one of the internet television technology standards for use by television broadcasters. Web television is a term used for programs created by a wide variety of companies and individuals for broadcast on internet TV. In smart TVs, the operating system is preloaded or is available through the set-top box. The software applications or apps can be preloaded into the device or updated or installed on demand via an app store or marketplace. In a similar manner to how the apps are integrated in modern smartphones. The technology that enables smart TV is also incorporated in external devices such as set-top boxes and small Blu-ray players, game consoles, digital media players, hotel television systems, smartphones and other network-connected interactive devices that utilize television-type display outputs. These devices allow viewers to find and play videos, movies, TV shows, photos and other content from the web, cable or satellite TV channel or from a local storage device. About the security, there is evidence that a smart TV is vulnerable to attacks. Some serious security bugs have been discovered and some successful attempts to run malicious code to get unauthorized access were documented on video. There is evidence that it is possible to gain root access to the device, install malicious software access and modify configuration information for a remote control, remotely access and modify files on TV and attached USB drives, access camera and microphone. There have also been concerns that hackers may be able to remotely turn on the microphone or web camera on a smart TV, being able to eavesdrop on private conversations. A common loop antenna may be set for a bidirectional transmission channel capable of uploading data rather than only receiving. This is all about the smart TV. Next, which I'm going to cover today, next is the next point, that is the Wi-Fi TV. So Wi-Fi is a popular wireless networking technology. Wi-Fi stands for wireless fidelity. It was invented by NCR Corporation or AT&T in Netherlands in 1991. By using this technology, we can exchange the information between two or more devices. Wi-Fi has been developed for mobile computing devices such as laptops, but it is now extensively using for mobile applications and consumer electronics like televisions, DVD players and digital cameras. There should be two possibilities in communicating with the Wi-Fi connection, that may be through access point to the client connection or client to client connection. Wi-Fi is one type of wireless technology. It is commonly as wireless LAN. Wi-Fi allows local area networks to operate without cable and wiring. It is making popular choice for home and business network. A computer's wireless adapter transfers the data into a radio signal and transfers the data into antenna for users. How it works? Wi-Fi is a high-speed internet connection and network connection without use of any cables or wires. The wireless network is operating three essential elements that are radio signals, antenna and router. The radio waves are keys which make the Wi-Fi networking possible. The computers and cell phones are ready with Wi-Fi cards. The radio signals are transmitted from antennas and routers, that signals are picked up by Wi-Fi receivers such as computers and cell phones that are ready with Wi-Fi cards. Whenever the computer receives the signals within the range of 100 to 150 feet for router, it connects the device immediately. The range of the Wi-Fi is depends upon the environment, indoor or outdoor ranges. The Wi-Fi cards will read the signals and create an internet connection between user and network. The device speed of the device using Wi-Fi connection increases as the computer gets closer to the main source, and the speed is decreases computer gets farther away. Many new laptops, mobile phones have inbuilt Wi-Fi card. You don't have to do anything, which is one of the best thing. If it is a free-based type of network connection, the user will be promoted with a login ID and password. The free-based network connection also well in some areas. The Wi-Fi network connection is created hotspots in the cities. The hotspots are a connection point of Wi-Fi network. It is a small box that is hardwired into the internet. There are many Wi-Fi hotspots available in the public places like restaurants, airports and hotel offices in universities, etc. Applications. There are many applications where we are normally use Wi-Fi TV. The first one is the mobile applications, business applications, home applications, computerized applications, automotive segment, browsing internet, video conference. About the advantages, wireless laptop can be moved from one place to another place. Wi-Fi network and communication devices without wire can reduce the cost of wires. Wi-Fi setup and configuration is easy than cabling process. It is completely safe and it will not interfere with any network. We can also connect internet via hotspots. We can connect internet wirelessly. About the disadvantages, Wi-Fi generates radiations which can harm the human health. We must disconnect the Wi-Fi connection whenever you are not using the server. Therefore, there are some limits to transfer the data. We can't able to transfer the data for long distance, and Wi-Fi implementation is very expensive when compared to the wired connection. So last point under this is the digital surveillance. So let's see. The word surveillance means to observe a specific area or to monitor the activities of the individual or a group. It is very useful to the government to maintain the social control, monitor and recognize threats and investigate criminal activity. The history behind the digital surveillance. The first CCTV system was installed by Siemens AG at Test Stand 7 to observe the launching of rockets, and later on it was used for observing public area. During 1990, digital multiplexing allowed more than one camera to record at once, which has increased the use of CCTV. It was commonly used in banks to record the evidence of criminal activity. The close CCTV, also known as video surveillance, it is the use of video cameras to transmit a signal to the specific place on a limited set of monitors. It differs from broadcast television in that signal is not openly transmitted, though it may employ point-to-point, point-to-multipoint or mesh wired or wireless links. Though almost all video cameras fit this definition, the term is most often applied to those used for surveillance in areas that may need monitoring, such as banks, stores and other areas where security is needed. Though video telephony is seldom called CCTV, one exception is the use of video in distance education, where it is an important tool. Surveillance of the public using CCTV is common in many areas around the world. In recent years, the use of body-worn video cameras has been introduced as a new form of surveillance, often used in law enforcement with cameras located on a public officer's chest or head. Video surveillance has generated significant debate about balancing its use with individuals' right to privacy even when it's public. In industrial plants, CCTV equipment may be used to observe parts of a process from a central control room, for example, when the environment is not suitable for humans. CCTV systems may operate continuously or only as required to monitor a particular event. A more advanced form of CCTV utilizing digital video records, that is DVRs, and provides recording for possibly many years within a variety of quality and performance options and extra features. More recently, decentralized IP cameras, perhaps equipped with megapixel sensors, which support recording directly to network-attached storage devices or internal flash for completely standalone operation. There are normally two types of surveillance, digital surveillance. First one, manual surveillance. It is very impractical and very costly, and lack of attention, it needs situational awareness. But if we'll go for the automation, it have computers cached, which helps to catch the video. It's cheaper than the manual surveillance, and people still have to deal with the alarms. So in the case of analog CCTV camera, this is the architecture of it. It consists of four things. Camera, which is a starting point of the CCTV systems. It having this night vision technology, which based cameras are used for low light conditions. It is having one monitor which operates view footage, which the operator view footage from central location on the monitor. It displays video from a single camera, and it accesses multiple cameras at the same video. Cable. The coaxial cable is used normally for transmitting video footage from cameras, and is very expensive and difficult to install. It having DVR, that is digital video recorder, to convert the analog footage to digital, which extends the storage capacity. It makes it easy to search at archived footage. It also allows user to stream video over a network for remote viewing from multiple locations. When digital surveillance comes into existence, it comes in two types, that is fixed camera and PTZ, that is the movable. In fixed camera, points is a single direction, monitors specific area of interest. It mostly installed in clearly visible areas. It is effective in capturing footage of suspicious activity, and direction of camera is set during installation. Next one is the PTZ camera, that is pan, tilt, zoom cameras. It is ideal for wide area surveillance. It gives the ability to remotely control pan, tilt and zoom functions to follow activity and to zoom in for detailed monitoring. It is an area where analog CCTV cameras fall behind their IP camera counterparts. So there are some, this is also known as IP camera based cameras. It is consists of four things. IP camera, it is front part of the system. Second one is the NVR, the network video recorder. It is a very crucial component of IP system, which is responsible for video monitoring event and event management and storage. Various compression techniques are used to optimize the storage, like MPEG-4. Third one is the power over Ethernet, that is PoE. With PoE, data transmissions from the camera and power to the camera are all relayed through a single Ethernet cable. And fourth one is the monitor. It placed at central location to view a footage, and it can be used to view the footage from single camera or multiple cameras. So, I hope you like the video. Today I have covered about the IPTV, wave, that is the Wave TV, Smart TV, Digital Surveillance and Wi-Fi TV. So if you like the video, kindly subscribe it, like it. Thank you so much.